And we'll always be campers.
What's up, YouTube? This is Hair Camps a Lot coming at you again. Today, we're going to do a different installment of my typical videos. I thought this would be really cool to do. Today, we're going to pit AI versus AI. And we're going to be doing it as a King of the Hill tournament. We're going to be doing these King of the Hill tournaments between the factions of the British, Americans, Japan, and Germany. We're not going to be able to include Russia due to the limited amount of planes between these four countries here. So first up, we're going to be doing the British against Japan. So we're going to go into the British and we're going to take the fighters only. No bombers in this one, only the fighters. So since the British has 1, 2, 3 fighters, 4, 5. And then we can probably squeeze in the Mosquito if need be. So 6 total against the Japanese, who has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is the point of this tournament is going to be, if you win, you proceed. If you lose, it's over for you. So the first up is going to be the Claude, the A5M Claude. Versus the Spitfire Mk-1A. And if the Claude or the Spitfire loses, if the Claude wins, then the next one's going to be the Mk-2A Spitfire. And so on and so forth. You're going to keep going until we get to the end. And once all the fighters are ran through, that country is eliminated. We're going to see through AI which country has the best fighters. Of course, a lot of it, different things depend on the situation, how the AI does in the fighting and stuff like that. But I have a feeling we're going to get a lot of surprises. So I'm very excited about this tournament. I'm going to be doing a video series on this tournament. And I'm really curious to see how it's going to work in the end. I'm going to figure out another way later on how I can squeeze in the Russians as well. That would be quite interesting to see how to do. But what we're going to do is, once we get our first two fighters, which is the Claude and the Spitfire Mk-1A, or 1A, or IA, I don't know. We're going to go into instant dogfight. We're going to be doing a Normandy map. AI skill is going to be on Ace. We're going to do realistic mode, so, you know, they can black out. And we're going to do a starting altitude of 2,000 meters. Now, at the 2,000 meter mark, in case any fighter, for instance, runs out of ammo, and he tries, once the AI pilot runs out of ammo, typically the AI pilot will try to run away and just fly around because they don't have no more ammo, so they're not willing to fight no more. That's just how the AI works. If the other plane, for instance, say if the Claude went up against, I don't know, the Mosquito, and the Mosquito runs out of ammo, the Claude is never going to catch the Mosquito. So it'll be chasing it forever around the map. In that case, we're going to call it a draw because neither plane was destroyed. And once you get a draw, we're going to go up. We're going to take it up to 5,000 meters and start again. And then if the same thing happens again, we're going to take it up to 7,000 meters. If the same thing happens again, we're going to take it up to 9,000 meters. And if the same thing happens again, at that point, we're going to take it back to 2,000 meters, and we're going to do 2 versus 2. So we're going to keep going until we can get total destruction of that other faction. So it's going to be a couple rounds, so we're going to see how that works. Also, for instance, if there's a plane that can't quite get inside the turn of another plane, because the AI plane will typically fly away, it'll get to a certain point on the map and it'll start flying in circles. I have seen before where the other AI will fly up and catch that plane, and sometimes in that turn circle the other AI plane cannot get inside their turn circle to get the kill. If the other plane runs out of ammo and the other plane gets to them and can still kill them, that counts as a kill because that other AI plane did not run out of ammo. But if the other AI plane just keeps following it around in a circle and it can't get inside the turn circle of that other plane to get the kill, it just keeps flying around, that counts as a draw. So we're going to end that match and we're going to go up to 5,000 meters and do it again. That is a draw. We only are looking for a shootdown in this tournament. If there is no shootdown, that's a draw. We're going to end it and we're going to start again. So first up, we're going to start with the Claude. We're going to start with the Spitfire for the Allies. The 1A. One. And we're going to start with the Claude for the Japanese side. Okay. So we're going to do the Spitfire, Mk-1A, and a A5M Claude for the first round. Okay, and then we're going to also, after the Spitfire or the Japanese team wins, whoever wins between those two, that's just going to be the winning faction for that side. Then we're going to take it over to the U.S. And we're going to start the U.S. Well, the U.S. doesn't have the P-40 Warhawk for some reason in the instant dogfight, so we're going to have to go with the 40C Tomahawk. And the German side, we're going to have to start with the BF-109E. So those are going to be the two planes that go against each other. And so on and so forth. Boom, 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 boop, boop, boop. Just keep going until we get all the way through all the German teams. They also have the BF-110, which is a, you know, an attack bomber fighter. So we'll include that as well. Because the U.S. has a lot of planes. So that's the only way I can equal it out. We're not going to do the premium planes, but we're going to go here, and then we're going to jump down to Aero Cobra, and then go all the way through all the fighters until we get to here, then we're going to go through all of these. So once we get to the Corsair, if the German team knocks out all these fighters, then the German team wins, and vice versa. If the U.S. knocks out all the German fighters, then the U.S. team wins. So that's the basis of this tournament. I hope you enjoy the footage, guys. I'm excited to make it. I'm excited to see it because I'm really excited to see how these fights play out. So I'm really ready to see this slugfest. I did a couple test runs and, man, it was really good. Some of the fights drew out really long, so I'm just really excited to see who's going to win in the end, because I have no clue. I have a slight idea, but in certain instances, you will be very surprised who wins. So I hope you guys enjoy these video series. This is called King of the Hill, Gunship Style. What's up, YouTube? This is round one of the King of the Hill tournament. We got the Spitfire versus the A5M Claude. These two planes are hitting at each other at this moment. The Claude is doing absolutely nothing because he means business today. This is a beautiful plane with a beautiful background. I did not do the Normandy map on this one by accident, so we're just going to work with this Papua New Guinea for this match. Spitfire is doing a little jinking already. The AI tends to do that on some planes. Here we go, we're almost at the merge, getting closer.
Round one, fight!
It's go time, people. Oh, Claude took a couple shots at the Spitfire. We are at the merge. Spitfire's going high, Claude's going low. Couldn't quite get a shot in there. The Spitfire turns on a dime, people. Beautiful pass there. Claude is actually surprising me a little bit on this match. But will he be able to keep up the energy? That is the question. Spitfire comes around there. Beautiful turn by the Spitfire. Got a little rolling action going on here. Who's going to pull out first? That is the question. Struggling a little bit with my... Oh, I thought he was going to get some shots on the Spitfire there. Claude's holding his own so far, people. I'm quite surprised with the Claude. But when will he run out of energy? That is the question. And who will be able to handle it better? Still got his little two-circle fight going on here. Oh, it looks like the Claude is running out of little energy there. Was that a mistake? Oh, he's pulling up on the Spitfire. Will he take a shot? No, he did not take a shot. Oh, Spitfire got some shots on the Claude on the head-on pass. Claude still looks like he's doing okay. He still got all his bits and pieces together. But the Spitfire is coming around on his tail. Going in for another head-on pass to the Spitfire. Probably not the smartest move. Oh, Claude is busting shots at the Spitfire. Oh, the Spitfire takes him out. And the Claude is down. The Spitfire Mk-1A wins the fight. Claude is going down. Beautiful fight by the Spitfire. The Spitfire advances. The Claude is down. The Claude is down.
Flawless victim. Fatality.
A beautiful shot by the winner there. The Spitfire moves on. And I think he takes on the Zero next. Be sure to stick around for our next installment of King of the Hill Tournament, where the Spitfire 1A takes on the A6M20. So I'm excited for this next match because I love the Zero, and I'm really excited to see what's going to happen between the Spitfire and the Zero. I'll see you guys next time.
Rushing round just aim for us. Kill streaks is all we lust. Let me hear your anger.
My fucking whore.
Your rage doesn't